Guys, I'm drinking the worst fucking energy drink I've ever tasted in my entire life. Oh my god, it's called Zevia? Not it, friends. Not it at all. It is making me burpy, though. The whole thing is carbonation! Like... You don't even taste any- Ugh, it's fucking gross. God. Let's play Sims. Okay, alright. We're in Italy. We're in the Italy world because I wanted to make pizza and shit. So we're gonna make a nice little Italian girl and we're gonna send her to fucking university. Okay. Okay.
So.
I keep thinking, like, if I drink it, it will make me feel better, but it doesn't, and it tastes disgusting.
So.
Oh my god, all these dudes we made?
Chabadu.
Who is this?
Balumi Lazikna?
I don't even know who this is. Right, let's start from scratch.
Azaznacht Bimba. Erkni Burr.
You said Italian, right? So she's gotta be like tan, like olive skin. Fine. I mean, her face is fine. I tried to play New Vegas, but seems being more funky. That's so wild. She's literally put contour on her. Holy shit. Fuck it. Fuck it. I think red's too dark. We love a matte look. I don't know why the game gets, like, so dark. It's weird, because it's, like, not dark for me. Like, I wonder if it looks that dark on Twitch. Why does it look so dark? I don't know why my game is always so dark. We're gonna save her for later. Probably. Give me a second. I don't know why my game is being weird. Vegas is not working. Sims is not working. You know what that means? I'm having a Steam Cloud error with New Vegas. And it's basically like... It's basically saying, like, if... I really want to get good at, I really want to continue playing Star Wars. But I feel like... I wonder if it will let me, actually. We're gonna try. Because I think... I'm in one of those I don't know what to play moves. But Star Wars is that one game where I'm like, oh, I love Star Wars, and then I never play it. Like, ever. Like, never, never. And it's online, so hopefully the Steam shit hasn't messed with it. We're on Nar Shaddaa right now. What is my security key? I shall tell you in a second. Nothing is fucking working with this shit. What's it like with all these, like, servers not working today? Game capture? Okay, let's try again. We're only in chapter one, holy. What do you guys think? Should I buy it? What's our mission? Talk to Jordan.
Alert! Scanning for weapons. Warning, visitor is armed.
Ignore the droids. Nutella says you're persistent, but I don't know what you think you'll find here. Sinjit's gone. Bankrupted by the war and sold off piece by piece for a tidy sum.
We're looking for, like, this drug.
Made me rich, but that life is over.
Oh, we're gonna flirt our way into this.
Master T'Lan, if you're everything I've heard, you must have stayed involved. I bet you could tell me stories about Sinjit. And Cyclone?
I can guess things. Doesn't mean my hands are in the basket. Besides, you're nobody to me. Why would I reveal confidential information to you?
Maybe it intrigues a girl.
You're playing games. I like that. Here's a story you might be interested in. A story about Vervgen, one of Sinjit's subsidiaries.
I like that.
Do go on. You've got my undivided attention.
Vervgen developed medical technology, mainly genetic modification serums. Not one of Sinjit's more profitable branches. When we put Vervgen on the market, we got some strange buyers. Paid cash and kept their names secret, took the company and all its technology.
What happened then?
Beats me. After the business sold, it wasn't my concern. Vervgen's offices were on the upper levels of the city. So far as I'm aware, the old buyers are still in charge. Now, that's the story I promised, and if you found that intriguing, maybe you can stick around a while. It's been a while since I last had company.
Sorry, but I've got to get to Vervgen.
That's a shame. I was beginning to enjoy myself.
You know how to leave them hanging, don't you?
Man, I thought I was going to say.
Don't bother the droids when you go, and leave Natula alone.
I got a space boyfriend on another planet, thank you very much. Leave me alone. Oh, hi, Una! Hello, man!
Una Tempest just subscribed. Hello, M-A-A-M.
I don't know what else to fucking do with my life. Thank you for the resub. I'm bored tonight. Yeah, it's Kirby. I fucking knew that. It's Kirby. Literally Kirby's Dreamland or some shit. I'm struggling. I slept for a little bit and I'm having a day. I don't know. Oh yeah, I gotta call this thing. How are you? How's work going?
Hello, Cypher. Always pleasant to speak. You know, I managed to slice into the Star Cluster's holocams. I got to see how you handle field work. You had Jordal T'Lan rather taken with you. Congratulations. I didn't think it possible to seduce a man like that.
I didn't think I can seduce anyone I want. Thank you very much. I'm a bad bitch. You gotta take an hour break. Rest your wrist. I'm not gonna stay on long anyway tonight.
Men like him aren't hard to manipulate.
Now
we know about Vervgen. A Sinjit Industries medical subsidiary purchased by a shadowy group of buyers. Those buyers were presumably members of the Terra Cell. The company was acquired to produce Cyclone and other technologies.
We need to take on Vervgen.
Not yet.
What are you having for lunch?
Soon. But not yet. I've located the Vervgen offices, but I'm unable to obtain personnel records. Their data
disgusting.
Is very well secured. I need you to set up surveillance. Slice into public terminals around
called
the building
Zevia.
Perimeter. And I can use holonet resources
like
to see and hear inside.
It's really gross. But I need caffeine to survive.
Say we're successful. Then what?
We analyze the situation. Determine our best approach.
This man is wearing no shoes.
Vervgen is located in the upper level industrial sites. The sector is overrun by corporate security. Some may carry Cyclone as a last resort. When you're done, come to Shadow Town. We'll meet in person.
Sure, yes,
watch
sir.
Watch your exit.
Toasted cheese sandwich. Oh, that's fire. I have like grilled cheese paninis all the time. I just put bread and then I put the cold cuts and then I put it on the pan. Put it in the pan. I don't know how to cook either. I hope no man is marrying me for my cooking skill. Ooh, woo. I'm gonna be the worst, like, home taker? Home? The bitch who runs the household. The one who cleans the house and runs the house. Yeah, that's not gonna be me. You're crazy if you think that's... I'll clean up after myself, but I'm not cleaning up after a man. Absolutely not. We don't do that in this household. Yeah, I can't cook either, which makes eating not so fun. Like, I just went to the store the other day. I'm so hyped because I bought Pop-Tarts. You guys have I'm assuming you have Pop-Tarts. But actually, I don't really know if you have Pop-Tarts.
Because every time I talk to
you, you're like, whoa, what is that? Can't do this. Really? You guys probably have better snacks than we do. Like, Tim Tams are pretty fire. That's the only one I know. I don't know the other ones. Time to do Just Chatting stream. I wanted to do a Just Chatting stream today, but I was like, what if I turn on the Just Chatting and I'm sitting here and there's no one here to chat to? Do you have to, like, start the conversation yourself and then, like, just hope people flutter in? Like, that's so wild. I ain't that charismatic. I don't know what to do. Oh, I'm so sleepy. And tomorrow morning, I have a fucking meeting at 11 a.m. The meeting in online, so it's not anything. I kind of like have my camera on and shit. Pay attention. Got two meetings tomorrow, a meeting on Tuesday, a meeting on Wednesday. Thursday, I'm free. Friday, I go in person. And then I start like that Wednesday or something. Can't believe we released another game. GG on that. Summer's art style, people seem to really love it. I think Summer excels at doing really cohesive designs. Like, I noticed this as well in The Last Asser, which is like, can create things that tie in all together. So it's like, I'll have like a mix mash of things because I'll use like Creative Common assets. But like, her sprites will match the backgrounds, will match the UI, and it'll kind of all tie in. Like how she textured a little bit of like Aster's sprite. How she textured Aster's I'm having an aneurysm. There was a paper texture on Aster's fucking sprite to make it look like the paper because there was letters and stuff, you know? That's what I was fucking thinking. I wish I could have edited more, but I'm really just fried. I can't even talk.
Medical attention.
Sell my junk? Oh, this is a gift? Okay. I could all sell these.
Be well.
I can do something with this. All right, make me look good.
That one's
not bad at all.
I'm giving her gifts. You guys can't see because my face is covering me. I don't think you guys really care much about Star Wars anyway. I'm just literally doing the story. I'm not doing anything too crazy or exciting.
Please use all products only as intended. Be well.
I was going to do New Vegas again, but it's Steam's being fucking weird today, so I don't really think
are currently
now.
Open for business.
But wait, I think I went to the... Okay, well, I don't really know where I'm supposed to go. I think I went the wrong way. I'm excited because I've been thinking about like what I want to do at the end of August, and like I've been in my head the past few days, obviously, as you know, because I've been bothering you about everything. Thank you for dealing with me, it's super appreciated. But like yesterday my friend said something to me while I was playing Apex, like we were playing Apex off stream, and I've known this guy for like 4 years, and he's like, I know you'd be really... It's all related, I swear. It's like, he's like, you'd be really, really good at Apex if you just stopped, like, overthinking and panicking. And I just was like, what? And he's like, your shot? He's like, you don't miss a single shot. Your aim is, like, so good. Like, when you shoot, you don't miss. He's like, but then they'll see you, or you'll see them and they don't see you, or they'll stand in front of you and shoot and you'll panic. And he's like, and then that's when you fuck up. Because you're panicking. And he's like, if you did, and he mentioned it like 2 times, so I was like, you know, he's on to something. And I was like, hey, that's like me off the game too. It's not just a game thing, it's like me panicking IRL. Like I panic about everything. And so I was thinking, like, how much of my feelings are like panic responses. Like, I feel like I jump to the worst conclusion before, like, I think about things. And granted, like, there's a reason, like, I feel the way I feel, but I think, like... After he said that yesterday, I was like... If it's even, like, manifesting in a game, like, I think I'm stressed. I think I'm overthinking everything and panicking and... Just for everything in my life. So, like, I took a step back yesterday. I hung out with, like, a friend that I haven't hung out in forever. I took, like, a deep breath and I was like, alright, use your brain, Anna. Think about things and, like, how you actually feel before. Like, how do you feel about this situation? And, like, how you genuinely fucking feel, not just, like... I'm not talking about Apex anymore, clearly, friends. Well, just in general, like, think about how you feel outside of that. And, like, is it a big deal? Is it a huge deal? All of these different steps I went through in my head yesterday. And I was like, bitch, even that's too much. Even that's too much. Like, I'm doing too much. Like, I'm stressed and panicked because I am investing too much of my energy into... things I shouldn't be investing in. And I like to... I know you guys don't believe in tarot card readings and stuff. And like the stars and the zodiac. Oh, you believe in the zodiacs, right, Una? Wait. Hold on. Because we're about to have a whole just chatting conversation. How do you feel about tarot card readings? Wait, hold on. We're about to get on to... Oh, everyone, wait, stop, because everyone I fucking tell is like, Anna, you're crazy, none of that shit's real. And it's like, I don't know if it's real, but a lot of it sounds scary accurate. Because I was watching something the other day, and I watch that shit because it makes me feel so, when I'm depressed, and like I feel like my life is going nowhere or whatever the fuck bullshit I'm in, I watch tarot card reading. Because I feel like... if I stumbled upon this specific one, you know, it must be for a reason. And some of them you can tell are a little shoddy. Like, you can tell, like, they were just pulling shit out of thin air. But some of them are crazy. And they also say, because they're doing general readings for every one of your sign, right? So I'm a Scorpio, so they're doing readings for all Scorpios. So you take what is yours and you let what isn't into the universe. And does that mean I'm gonna follow the stars and their advice to a T? No, but it makes me feel better about myself. So anyway, I was watching one the other day. And they're talking about love connection or some shit. And I was like, whatever. Because they always talk about, like, a new person coming in. It's always a new person coming in. It's like... That doesn't apply to me. Like, the new person does not apply to me. But they were like, yeah, you know, you're, like, pulling in fire sign energy. And I was like, huh. And they were like, yeah. Okay, you're pulling in real Aries energy right now. And I was like, I gotta go. This is too much. How? Some of them are really accurate. And I don't care what anyone says. Just guess who's an Aries, that's all I'm saying. I fucking can't. Tarot card readings, they just make me feel so good. Whether they're true or not. Do you do the readings? Or, like, have you I don't know how you would even do it. My friend has tarot card reading. And she has, like, the pendulum or whatever. And her reading was accurate, too, because she gave me a reading a while back. And it was like, you're getting too distracted from your work. Or you're using work to distract yourself. And I was like, damn, how'd she know? I don't know. It's scary shit. Also, I've been reading, like, I remember that one conversation we had about, like, compatible, zodiac signs. Una, do you know this? Let me just check my chat. Your friend sometimes lurks in my chat, so I'm just... Before I say anything. I like to spy on who's in my chat, y'all. Because, like, it always says one viewer, and I'll have, like, four people in my chat list. Don't they say? Wait, hold on. I kind of want to read this real quick. We're taking a detour. For 5 seconds. Taking a detour. I don't give a fuck. If it logs me out. I want to read, like, what it says about Leos, because I heard they were, like, not, like, I heard, like, let's just see. I'm gonna read it, and we'll go through it. Oh, I'm excited. I love talking about the Zodiac. Like, I'm, a lot of the men I talk to are, like, stop, none of that shit's real. I don't give a fuck. Some of it sounds really accurate, so I don't care. Leo is represented by the lion, clearly. Spirit, it's a fire sign thing. That's why they had so many similarities. Fire sign, bro. Kings and queens of the celestial jungle, they're delighted to embrace royal status. They're vivacious, theatrical, passionate. They love to bask in the spotlight and celebrate themselves. I always want to read. Give me a reading on my love life. Unless it's bad. If it's bad, then I don't want it. I only want to hear you're getting married and moving your state and having 3 kids running around. 3 kids is a lot. I don't know if I could have 1 kid. Yeah, not for me. Natural leaders, and they enjoy cultivating friendships and romances that are artistically and creatively inspired. Playful. Yeah, create. That seems right. Like, from what you told me. Like, artistically and... Because Mans was pulling out a lot. Like, some of the stuff, like, when you were like, this sounds like a romance novel, I was like, yo, it really kind of does. Like, I don't know. Every Leo perceives him or herself as a celebrity. Isn't Kai a Leo? I feel like Kai doesn't give me that vibe. You don't want that without the stuff. My connection, like, hold on. My connection is like, it's so accurate. It's like, it's like you're gonna put out his fire. He's a fire sign, and I'm a water sign, and it's like basically like,
rise and shine.
You're gonna put out his fire, and I was just like, well, that doesn't sound very nice. That doesn't sound very, They always say, oh, I'm dying in Star Wars. Oh, I fucking, let me move over. I fucking camped over here. Holy, we're doing this chat in perspective. Yeah, so apparently Scorpios are like really intense and always in their field. I don't know about Scorpio males. You would know better than I would, but... Because aren't like Scorpio males like really like the worst? Don't they hate... Number one, I heard is Gemini men and then Scorpio men. No, don't shoot me. I'm trying to get out of here. Why does everyone hate Gemini though? Like, that's the thing. Why do they hate you guys? The guy I blocked was a Gemini, remember? I mean, well, it proved correct, right? Wasn't guy number one a Scorpio? I don't know if I should be outing your information, but I feel like you said it on stream. I feel like that was a thing. Alright, you're staying back here, okay, bitch? And if you get killed, it's on your own. I think it's a Scorpio man thing. Oh. Playful Leos have no problem leaning into drama-fueled romances that are perfectly suited for the tabloid. In fact, they prefer them. After all, every Leo perceives himself as a celebrity. These astrological divas never get tired of lavish dinners, exclusive parties, or decadent designer wear. Sounds high maintenance for all the baggage that they bring, huh? Shade. The Leo is ruled by the sun, the dazzling celestial body that governs life and vitality. The sun never goes retrograde, and likewise, Leos are renowned for their stability, loyalty, and consistency. Stability, loyalty, consistency. Oh no. Lions love to watch their mates succeed until they feel threatened. Wait, hold on. This is full of drama. Wait, hold on. I'm actually here for this. It feels like it would be exhausting to date a Leo. Ultimately, Leo's own hubris is the greatest threat to their happiness. They're known for their ambition and determination, but above all, Leos are celebrated for their remarkable bravery. Represented by the strength card. Hold on, I kind of want to change the game to just chatting. Is that okay? For a little. Since I have your attention. And then I'll put it back. Okay. I had music on over here too. Okay. I'm into this conversation and I just put on stream to hang out. I don't really give a fuck about gaming. I just don't really know how to fill with it. Leo is represented by the strength card. They're very brave. It depicts the divine expression of physical, mental, and emotional fortitude. Fearless optimists who refuse to accept failure, Leos will find their deep wells of courage grow as they mature. This is what you're like in bed, according to your zodiac sign? Are we getting saucy? It's not after hours yet. Oh, this is who you're compatible with. Do you know man's sign or nah? Aries. Squid. I'm gonna choke to death. Don't date an Aries. Don't date a fucking Aries, please. Oh my god, my guy's a fucking Aries, and I always, I fucking can't. I can't. Granted, there's a lot of other issues besides the fucking month he was born in, but anyway. Okay, well, just so happens that this article I clicked that talks about who they're most compatible with, Aries is first on the list. Let's go through it. They're known for their fiery energy, yes. Exciting impulsivity, yes. And insatiable desire to be the best, also yes. On a great day, dating an Aries is like partnering with a fierce, unstoppable warrior. On a bad day, however, their strong will and temper tantrums can become juvenile. They may become cranky if they don't have enough physical affection, including snuggling. As a result, their zodiac signs compatibility works well with sensual signs ruled by Venus, such as Taurus or Libra, to even out their intensity. Anyway, not either of us, but here we are. In addition to Libra and Taurus, all the air and earth signs can help mellow out these rams. Wait, are you an earth sign or an air sign or a water sign? Or not a fire sign? Fire sign? No. Earth? You're triple. It says air signs can help mellow out these rams. No, like me, I'm the worst. Like, it's like, it's fire and water. It's literally fire and water is like the worst. Bling with an Aries is not for the faint of heart, Una. No! What am I supposed to say? Give me another word. No, actually, you don't give me another word, because I was there for Una's stream when y'all said daddy. Anyway. Two fire signs need to be mindful of fights and make extra effort to listen. Oh, I already fucking said it. Oh, hear this shit. If an Aries pairs with an emotional water sign, such as Cancer, Scorpio, or Pisces, they will need to practice patience. I fucking said sign four times. Give this man his points back. I'm fried. They will need to practice patience to ensure they don't accidentally hurt their sensitive feelings. Stop, because that's my big problem. Is he'll say he'll say something, and I'll be like, that's kind of mean. I'm too sensitive. Anyway, let's read the Gemini one. I'm not here for that. I'm here for you. That made me sad. It's a literally water putting out the fire. It's like, this is your worst match, Ubu. It's fucking Aries, man, bruh. It's the, impulsivity is exciting, but also, the biggest issue I think we run into, like, my biggest thing is, like, he'll, move the fuck on right away. Like, that's right away. Like, we'll get into something, and I'm, like, way emotionally invested in it, and I'll be thinking about it for 2 or 3 days. And I'll bring it up like 3 days later, and he's like been over it for like 10 minutes after it happened. And he's just like, really? And I'm like, I've been losing sleep over this, and you're just chilling? Wow, we love it here. Anyway, Gemini. May 21 to June 20. Gemini has a reputation for being the heartbreaker of the zodiac. See, this, I feel like I. Una tells me she's a Gemini, but Una also tells me that her that her sign doesn't. I'm fucking anxiously playing this. That her sign doesn't fit her. Also, Bellows, I never said fucking hi, by the way. I'm so sorry, sir. Hello, welcome in. How's streaming been going? Bellows' stream is always popping, by the way. Honestly, like, Mans always has like 15 plus viewers, and I'm just like, damn. Teach me the way. How do I get to be relatable and fun? Your ex used to call you a heartbreaker, but like as a cute thing, or like a, you're like a heartbreak, like a little term of endearment? Or like, oh yeah, in a flirty way. My favorite nickname is Babe. Like, that's it. Like, I just love Babe. That's my absolute favorite. Like, Babe is it. I'm pretty basic. I don't need to be called anything else. You feel like you're intruding on a conversation? No, we're talking about zodiac signs. Because I was playing Star Wars. And then I asked Una, well, I asked chat if Una was the only one in chat. Yeah, so I asked Una if she watched like tarot card readings and things like that, because they keep making fun of me, my friends, especially my male friends, for watching tarot card readings and stuff, because they're like, yeah, we don't believe in the stars or whatever. But I was saying, like, I know it was like a general reading because it's on YouTube. Like, it's a general reading for all Scorpios. But she said some shit. And she was like, you're attracting like fire sign energy, and the guy I'm talking to has fire sign energy. So I was like, this is kind of wild. So I was asking Una what she thought about that, and then we started getting into zodiac sign. And so now I'm reading who we're most compatible with, just for funsies. Bellows, what's your sign? So yeah, we'll teach you. Oh yeah, so on a bad day, when's your birthday? There's like three different signs. I don't know about all the fucking, like, I don't know about the triple signs Una was talking about. Or one. Yeah, you're an Aries. March 21st to April 19th. Yeah, you're an Aries. You're the guy we were just talking about. Here. That was the compatibility, but I can read your regular, I think. Tell me if it's correct. Oh, Aries personality, male. Yeah. They're known. I don't care about all this shit. Is a fire sign. These men are passionate, daring, and full of energy. They are known for being impulsive and headstrong, so an Aries man is not someone you want to cross. Don't fuck with Bellows, clearly. But if you can handle his fiery temper, you will find an incredibly loyal and protective partner. An Aries man is a natural leader. This man's got 15 people in his chat. You can't imagine Bellows being angry? I feel like sometimes they're not completely accurate, these things. A man with an Aries zodiac sign is also very independent, so don't try to tie them down. Yeah, this is where we are, Una. This is where I am. They need space. Wait, they need space. I gotta go. They need space to roam and conquer, so if you're looking for a settled relationship, an Aries man is probably not the right choice for you. Gotta go. Ugh. You want to get married? Better not pick an Aries. Bellows, is that true? Can't settle down? But the crazy part, though, is like, I feel like he wants to. I feel like he, like, genuinely wants to. I just feel like, you know, It's like a fire that you can't tame. Like, literally. It's a fire you can't tame. If you can handle an Aries man with his temper and give him the freedom he needs, you will find a loving and faithful partner. No, you can. It says as long as you give him the freedom that he needs. So, it's the accepting the time away kind of thing. And that's hard for a Scorpio because Scorpios are very emotional and attached. But I feel like me specifically, I fall into like codependent patterns. So I feel like it's a good thing that I don't have access constantly to this bullshit. Because the last guy, I don't know what sign he was. I don't remember his birthday. I don't remember anything about him. I fucking pushed that shit out of my mind. But I was codependent on him like so bad. Because he was like there whenever I needed to talk to anyone. And he was like messaging me while I was at work. Okay. You're gonna do the opposite of everything it said for her. It says you're a natural born leader. I'll take it. I bet you for Scorpio it says I'm a little bitch who's in my feels. Aries man traits. The Aries man is a natural leader, full of confidence, always ready for action. He's not afraid of taking risks and is always up for a challenge. Not only is he fiercely independent, but loyal to those he cares about. Fiercely independent drives me insane, but anyway. An Aries man is always moving forward and looking for new opportunities. He's a great communicator and an excellent listener. Well, who said... Y'all heard the same thing I heard, Una? Y'all heard excellent communicator? Because I didn't. An excellent listener, 110%. That's an issue on my end. A listener, yes. He'll sit there and listen to me, like, for hours. And he won't interrupt me or anything. The communication. If you're talking about expressing yourself, if I ask, he'll tell me. It's just...
What is love? Baby, don't hurt me. Don't hurt me. No more.
So long. Isn't real. Communication is hard. He's always honest and straightforward. Have you ever told a lie in your life, Bellos? Don't lie now. He has a strong sense of justice and always fights for what is right. Optimist and always sees the glass half full. Natural born leader. They said that like 6 times. So others are drawn to his confidence and charisma. Aww. Wow, they're drawn to you. He's always up for a good time and knows how to have fun. He's a great friend and always there for those he cares about. Oh, she fucking really said you can't lie. Why don't you just chat? I'm literally incapable of sitting here and fucking talking. Literally. Aries men are known for being... honest and upfront. They also are known for being... Oh my god, you guessed it. Leaders. They literally said it 4 times. Aries men tend to be very black and white when it comes to ethics. They believe in doing what is right and wrong and do not waver from their beliefs. They're very straightforward and speak their minds. They are not afraid to tell it like it is and do not sugarcoat their words. Want to hear about an Aries in a relationship? Aries men are known for their fiery passion and assertive nature. So when it comes to love, they often gravitate towards equally passionate and assertive partners. Ubu. Aries men are also notoriously independent, so they often need a partner who can give them space they need to explore and grow. I'm owning that. I'm owning passionate and assertive. I'm hella assertive. Here are a few signs that an Aries man is compatible with an Aries woman. I don't give a fuck about Aries women. Anyway. And then it says, are... Oh my god. Scorpio and Aries share a passion for life and often feel a draw to each other. However, their different approaches to life can sometimes lead to conflict. They can prove to be a very strong couple if they can work together in a relationship. We'll never know. Seven signs an Aries man is in love with you. Oh no, are we going through this? Hold on. If an Aries man is interested in you, he'll find excuses to be around you as much as possible. Oh, we already failed. Never mind. Gotta go. I'm turning off this article. I want to know what you're doing and who you're with, and he'll try to be a part of your life as much as you can. Gotta go. Anyway, I don't want to read this anymore. Anyway, what are we reading about the Gemini? Literally felt the first hurdle. Gotta go. Oh, that's Cancer, bro. I can't even read. Gemini has a reputation for being the heartbreaker. On a bad day, can be flighty and unreliable. As a result, sensitive water signs or devoted fire signs may get fed up. Are you flighty and unreliable? Bellows, why do you want to see me suffer? I hate astrology too. Anyway. Communication is like... Never mind. Geminis are air signs and the social butterflies of the stars. Oh, a social butterfly. I agree with that. They need constant stimulation through communication and daily adventures. And yes, that consistent stimulation rule applies to the bedroom. Dun dun dun. So hey, sensitive Scorpio might be a great fit because while they're emotional, they're also the sign of sex. Well, that's the first one that's actually said the Gemini and a Scorpio are compatible. Wild. Geminis are natural wordsmiths. And like-minded air signs, Libra and Aquarius sincerely appreciate their clever wit and vivacious intellectualism. For this sign, however, opposites really attract. The Sagittarius and Gemini match is one of the most dynamic pairings of the zodiac. These inverted signs are both natural wanderers, and when linked, they can form an incredibly creative, fun-loving power couple. Well, I think that Sagittarius, yeah. I'm sorry, I got distracted by a thing. Oops. What the fuck was I on? Alright, we did Aries. We did Gemini. Scorpio. Fucking. This shit I took from the kids' prize box in the fucking office, I swear. I'm not stealing things from kids, but like they had extra. And I like to fuck around. You know, keeps me busy. Scorpio is one of the most intense signs of the zodiac. These powerful water signs use their incredible intuition to manifest their goals and approach their passions with relentless dedication. Oh, it's kind of nice. It's no surprise that they also make extremely dedicated lovers. Lovers is not the word that you banned, so it's fine. And they make... The L word I can't say. Like their life. Oh, they have sex like their life depends on it. I should have just read that first. was fueled by very sad feeling. My wrist was fucking hurting like hell today because I played Apex yesterday for 8 hours. So I was gonna be, today I was gonna finish writing the ending of Midnight's Route, but I've been having a week, so I feel like I deserve to just lay down in my bed and stare at the ceiling a little bit. While some signs balk at Scorpio's intensity, fellow water signs embrace Scorpio energy. This sign is also recognized for its magnetic sexuality. Wow. Y'all heard it here first, guys. Their sexual appetite is best satiated by its opposite sign, Taurus. Interesting. So matched with ravenous Scorpio, this couple makes for a truly erotic pairing. Dun dun dun. Anyway, literally don't care about any other sign. While on paper, Taurus pairs best with Scorpio, fellow Earth signs, Capricorn and Virgo will also enjoy hot sex. So what I learn is every time I read about my zodiac sign, the first part will be like, you're a really hard worker and you're really emotional. And the second part will be like, going in depth about how much rough sex I'm gonna have in my lifetime. And how good I am at it. Thanks for telling me. It's literally going in detail about the Scorpio sex life. Hot sex, secure and safe partner. The most challenging signs for Scorpios can be air signs, as they tend to be elusive, and Scorpios do not hide. If you try to avoid a relationship conversation with them, they will come for you with their stinger. Not for real. I'm like, this don't sound like me. Gotta go. Wait, what sign were you supposed to be with? A Sagittarius? Look, let's hear it. Symbolized by the archer is ready for an adventure. These fire signs. You're always with the fire sign. An air sign is not good for me because... No. An air sign is good with you in the bedroom. Because of the emotional connection to the intimacy or whatever the fact of with sex. But I don't think it's like anything long term. Yeah. Because for Scorpio, can confirm like that that's the way for like the ultimate emotional connection, I think. So it's like, it's not so much like fuck to fuck, you know? I'm gonna guess. But like that's how you connect emotionally. And so that passion with your whatever the fuck it said, eroticism. But I don't know. I'm sure it's not all Scorpio. I'm sure it's just the really hot ones. Like-minded fellow fire signs, Aries and Leo perfectly complement the wildfire. Opposite sign, Gemini, is also a terrific match because Gemini and Sagittarius believe in living life to its fullest. And these inverted signs may support each other's journey towards self-actualization. Cute. Ain't gotta worry about. What your zodiac sign says about your love life and approach to dating? Alright, we're gonna read that one. I'm an astrologer, just self-appointed right now. Is Bello still here? We got the Aries man right here. Aries are the first sign of the zodiac and are known for their impulsivity. When it comes to dating, Aries don't do demur. These fire signs are ruled by Mars, the planet of action. Aries are quick to fall in love and aren't afraid to let the world know through serious and sometimes excessive public displays of affection. Oh. Guess he's not in love. I gotta stop reading these. Keep its arrow strikes these passionate rams. They'll likely try to put a ring on it faster than you can say we just met. Anyway. Who are you marrying, Bellus? Though it may be tempting to let a vivacious Ares sweep you off your feet, approach with caution. Ares often set unrealistic expectations on your relationships, only to be severely disappointed when the honeymoon phase ends. Ares must remember that the process of getting to know someone takes time, hard work, empathy, and patience. Allow couples to create a solid foundation built on trust, loyalty, and mutual respect. Now that's something worth waiting for. My ex clearly. Oh, me? Oh, they're saying my ex. You want me to marry you? I have only room in my heart for one Aries. I'm so sorry. He stresses me out too much. I don't have enough mental energy to deal with literally any other man ever in my life ever again. One Aries out, one Aries in. Alright, listen. This level of commitment is more than I've gotten in the last 7 months. I'll take it. Let's go. Holy. He said, I will be the only Aries. Guys, I'm pissed because I fucked up the fucking slinky. You know when you fuck up the top and then the rest of it's not even? Slinky. Bellus, I'll marry you if you fix the slinky. It's annoying. I'm about to make it worse. I'm about to make it so worse. Oh, I'm so fucking sad. Anyway.
I got you Bapia's bits for a new slinky.
Thank you for the 100 bits for my new slinky. I appreciate it. I'm just gonna steal one from the prize closet when I go back to work on July 5th. Don't worry about it. What color should I get? What's your favorite color, Bellus? It's already bad. I mean, Ruth. Alright. Oh, I fixed it! Never mind! I'm a dedicated bad bitch like my Zodiac said. What has he done for me lately? Got you a new slinky? Turned me down to play Final Fantasy 16 this morning to hang out with his friend. So, nothing. I can't. Oh my god. Just kidding. I talk a lot of shit about him. But he's okay. I wouldn't be dealing with him if he was not okay. Where do we say? Let's see. Gemini next. Oh, I fucking skipped you, I think. Oh, no, wait. Oh, yeah, I skipped you. Gemini is the first air sign and is represented by the twins. You'd fight the stars for me? No one's ever said that to me before. Mm-hmm. Wow. Anyway, when's the wedding? When's the wedding? This is fucking gross. Right now? Una, are you legal? Oh, she's in Australia. I was gonna say, are you legally allowed to marry me? Are legally allowed to do the, what do they call? The vows? I fucking can't. I had a guy I used to follow on Twitch. And I used to joke about, like, dating him, like, as a joke. And that was our thing. We were, like, joking about dating. And somebody, like, flipped it out of context and was, like, sending it to everyone in the community. And it got really weird. Because I was talking about, like, it was out of context. But it was, like, something, like, sexual. And, like, he clipped it and was sending it to everyone. And I was like, can you not? Can you not? Man really said gotta go. Oh, he didn't say gotta go. He's saying you're moving in and we're getting a dog? Is that what that means? I'm stupid and old. Fellas, how old are you? Wait, I should ask that. Maybe I shouldn't ask that. Don't tell me. I don't want to know. Oh, I got a new follower. Bruh, I hate group chats. I fucking hate group chats. Because, like, it'll go from, like, one person will send off, like, 15 messages. And then I got the little 15 on the bottom. What kind of dog we getting? Because, wait, hold on. Because my partner said I can't have a dog. My partner doesn't like dogs. We can get a cat, but not a dog. That's a red flag, if I've ever heard one. Like, Bellos is getting me. At least I get a cat with this guy, though. Unless you have two cats, so he's lying to me already? And we didn't even get married yet. That's so cringe. BRB, I'm texting someone right now to come defend my honor. I'm not literally get married before you lie. Dem and I often have a bad reputation for being two-faced. These friendly, that's what you were talking about? Are you two-faced, Duna? Do you tell me something and then turn around and you're talking bad about me? That's so not nice. Bellos, I bet she talked bad about you too behind your back. This two-faced Gemini. Crazy. I just want us to all be heartbroken tonight, Una, since my wedding just got canceled. Anyway, I forgot you guys can see everything, so you are watching me struggle with my Welch's fruit snack. Bellos made an alt account, messaged you, and then you talked bad about Bellos, the alt account. And I bet you the alt account was like, that Bellos guy really sucks, huh, Una? And you were like, yeah. Damn, I really got broken up with. My 5-second relationship. These friendly, sociable air signs rarely have nefarious intentions. In fact, Geminis are best known for their talkative, spontaneous, and upbeat dispositions. The Gemini seduction technique corresponds with their general attitude. These twins love to chat! Aww. That's true. Una, you seem to really like to have, like, a chatty relationship. That's a good thing. I feel like talking is a good thing. They get to know people. They're all about storytelling, yes. Jacks of all trades often have lots of quirky hobbies. Have a stamp collection, so does Gemini. Love hot air ballooning, sign Gemini up. Gemini are the energizer bunnies of the zodiac. But if you're someone who values cozy quality time, there may be an issue down the line. Oh? The twins need to stay active constantly, which sometimes make it difficult to get to know the sign on a deeper, more personal level. Bellos is still here, it's making me nervous. My ex. Damn. How will I recover? You're shallow and two-faced. Hell yeah! Bad bitch era. My ex. If only my other Aries was available right now for me to cry on his shoulder. Oh wait, Aries men, they don't do that shit, right? I don't remember what the fuck we just read. Gemini must work to realize that quiet evenings at home are not time wasted. And FOMO only goes so far when cultivating a new relationship. Wait, is that true? You know you like to go out a lot and stuff? Or you prefer to stay in and like cuddle and watch a movie? Oh, she said it's calling me out. Oh, you rather go out? Who hate being alone? She wants to go out and do stuff. That's the opposite for me. Let me stay inside my house. Let's do Leo. I'm curious. It was so hot in my room, my fruit snacks are all soft. Just stay at my house. I have a spare bed. You talking to Bellows? Or talking to me, Uwu? Because I was gonna say, like, I'd probably be a better bed companion than Bellows. You heard my zodiac sign, right? Or maybe I shouldn't say that. Maybe I should bring up my vicious sex life on stream. Leo lovers value the concept. Oh wait, I skipped a whole bunch. I don't know if I could handle another Aries. And we just read that Geminis and Scorpios have like intense sex. Like, we just read that. So I don't really know. Like, why have an Aries man when you can have a Gemini woman, am I right? I'm right. Why have a Scorpio woman when you can have a Gemini woman? Two-faced means more fun. Probably. I think. Also, she probably wouldn't break her slinky. She probably would have a nice pink slinky that's not broken. Have you ever dated a celebrity? I definitely have not. Wow. What was your celebrity crush, guys? Also, I want to know if it's different for you, Una, because you live in Australia and you're going to say something wacky. David Tennant? Mine was Jesse McCartney. I don't even know who the fuck David Tennant is. Who the fuck? Oh my god. This guy? Oh, the Doctor Who man? I didn't watch Doctor Who, never. Never, never. Born 1971? Oh, she liked the old man even when she was young. Oh my god. Mine was Jesse McCartney, the blonde boy. I used to sing Beautiful Soul all the time. Wow, we better get DMCA just to watch this video. I think it's worth it. Alright. Slight tangent. Did I say... No, I didn't say that. Why would I say that? Why would I talk about old men? This is the love of my life when I was little. Like, I don't give a fuck, like... To keep that it's true? I saw Jesse McCartney when I was like 10, shirtless in this video, and I lost my shit. And it wasn't even like he was scrawny, wasn't I like... Bus is here too. Bus, what's your zodiac sign? Welcome in. All right. Capricorns work hard to build safety and security in their lives. They aspire to create solid foundations for their careers, homes, and romantic partnerships. Oh, that's cute. And Bell's is my cousin friend. He's little. He's not little. He's littler than me. So I think it's cute. They may look like business on the outside, but these secrets are... Oh, never mind. I don't want to read that. Never mind. Leave the chat. And leave the chat, Nick. I don't want to talk about kinks. Oh my god. When's your birthday, Bus? That's all I need to know, and then I can read it off this chart. Capricorn's approach to life is not for everyone. Fiery Aries and agreeable Libra can become frustrated by their stoicism, and Capricorn can also grow exhausted by the flippant nature of these signs. When dating an Aries or Libra, Capricorn must remember that their lovers are not their assistants, and that best partnerships are those built for mutual respect. Send you the link. There's a bunch. You want to know about your love life, or you want to know about your personality? Capricorn men are grounded, practical, in control of their emotions, and steadily move toward one success after the other. Would you match well with an Aries? October 12th, he's like a Libra, right? Let me see. Yeah, you're a Libra. I guess you're right. Libras are the best. Nick Dillon's a Libra. Libras are good because they're like the mediators. They're like the calm, like, doesn't take a side. Dillon's different, my brother, because, you know. Motive change. Bus, don't listen to him. He literally broke up with me 5 seconds ago. You're not, don't be keen. Don't fall for his shit. Don't fall for his impulsive Aries bullshit. He literally just broke up with me after proposing to me in like 5 seconds. And then changed his mind immediately. And then said I couldn't have a dog. What the fuck? You're gonna give him my slinky? What the fuck? Libras are charming, dapper air signs who enjoy connoisseurship and are often found admiring modern artwork at a gallery, sipping wine in a vineyard, or shopping for the finest clothing. They are also one of the most epic flirts of the zodiac. I fucking read Bello's comment and literally fucking a bus after my oil change. I'm leaving. They literally, like, I feel like I'm in Una's chat all over again. I would come in and then they were just like, can I, maybe I shouldn't say it. Maybe it's not appropriate. It was never your slinky to begin with. Wait, hold on. Y'all, the fact that you and Una are the same fucking pink is fucking me up. It was never your slinky to begin with, X? Oh. Well, his first mistake is he calls me X. Yeah. Literally two hot babes and yet they're seducing each other. Crazy. Holy fuck. The pink is fucking me up. Yeah, honestly, that's how we judge whether or not I like you. If you call me X, it's a little sus. I don't know her. Damn, Bellows is really whoever's gonna marry you? Like, whoever's gonna say yes? Wow, wild. Crazy. He's literally flipping at the turn of a dime. Wild. Nick, are you still in chat? What time are you going to bed? Did it say it? Geminis were flighty? I don't remember. What do we say about Libra's fellow air signs? Gemini, who give Libra a run for their money on the flirting front, and Aquarius deeply admire this sign's appreciation for art and culture, and enjoy cultivating their refined taste within these well-matched air sign partnerships. Wow, so we have an air sign, Libra, Bus, and an air sign, Gemini, Una? Wow, crazy. Is your oil change? You're using synthetic oil instead of the cheap stuff? Too much air energy. Una said, anyway, I want a fire energy. Fire energy stresses me out. What if I marry me instead? Stop! He's gonna break my heart. I can't. Anyway. By the scales, love being in pairs, making Aries and fellow fire signs an exciting partner. Well, I guess, okay, that answers that. I guess they're into Aries as well, huh? Aries are known for their fierce independence, so when these two signs couple, they often create compelling counterbalances, as reflected in the infamous duo Bonnie and Clyde. Often, this sociable sign can become overly consumed with their public image. This people-pleasing sensibility may rub Cancers and the other water signs the wrong way, so Libra should prove their dedication by paying extra attention to their lover, especially in group settings. Who's next? Let's go. Y'all really sad. Talk about whatever you want. I'm really out here doxing my messages to y'all. What's the other one we were reading? I got distracted. You could do all the planets? What does that mean? Oh, like, so it's not just, like, whatever your sign is. It's, like, your sun and your rising and your fucking... What? I didn't know about all that. Your shadow self. Emily, hello. How's Derek's room going? Good. It just came out, right? Like 2 days ago or like yesterday? I suddenly ran out of things to talk about. They ran out of articles. Oh. the best summer makeup trend for your zodiac? Alright. What are you guys up to, friends? Chat. How's it going with you? I'm only halfway through my energy drink. I like how it says Una's not a viewer in the chat list, but I'm literally watching her chat. Crazy. Oh, let's look at Libra again. Is Bus still here? Or not? Libra man. No, going back to work. One more. Then I'm gonna see if my cousin still wants the game. I don't know if he's still in chat. Okay. And report back to him if he's working. Okay. Libra is ruled by Venus, which is the planet of love and pleasure. The fact pops out Libra's characteristics in men. They are natural givers when it comes to their loved ones. They can provide extreme pleasure, unearthly love, and a balanced approach to your life. They can respond mindfully to anything, thus never speak irrelevant stuff. To be in good books of a Libra man, you need to show him your pleasant personality. They are social beings and thus expect to see the same in you in order to indulge with you better. They love balance in their lives and thoughts. Libra man allow them to speak about their ideas to anyone who is interested in hearing him out. A Libra man is a great team player but can never be a leader. Oh, that's why he needs fellows. The leader. It is hard for them to make decisions promptly. Libra man never signs up for a monotonous and boring life. They are uncomplicated beings and stay away from drama. Well, Baxter's comes out this year too. Damn, they're working, GB Patch. They always make sure that they don't hurt people by what they say, thus they speak in a very balanced manner. Libra traits consist of being a balanced and fair being. They are most neutral and unbiased people you will ever come across in your life. If you want to include a Libra man in any of the decision-making processes, then be ready to see a result which might be unsuitable for you, but which would be perfect. They are very particular in maintaining peace around them. It is because they avoid confrontation and don't want anything to do with arguments. They never rush into things, be it deciding something for their future, giving advice, or finding someone for them. Libras are very casual and easygoing. Libra men can get along with almost everyone because they know the art of comforting people. A Libra man is very sensitive but masculine. They are balanced people, so never experience emotional outbursts, and they are very charming and intelligent. Cute. All right. Some of the star shit's right. Well, I feel like most of it was right. Yeah, just good boy, boss. We've been known that. Thanks very much, stars. We've been known that. All right, let's see who the fuck is streaming, because I just wanted to do a quick little stream because I was bored anyway. All right, let's fucking see who we can raid. We're gonna raid Deku because he's lurking in my chat. We're talking about how great you are. Literally, we're talking about how great you are. First of all, before I log off, Bus, like, I miss Bus. Like, I miss Bus coming into chat and then, like, me being like, cute boy Bus. Like, I miss Bus. We literally did Libra and it said nothing wrong about you. Like, for all of us, we had our faults. And then for Libra, it was like, you're the best. Like, I can sum it up for you super quick. Like, balanced, fair, most neutral and unbiased people you will ever come across. So if you need help with a decision, go to Bus. Go to Libra. It said a Libra man in, Libra man compatibility. Gemini and Libra are the most compatible signs. So you're marrying Una. Duh. They complement each other in so many ways that the match is somewhat magical and dreamlike. Libra accepts the duality of a Gemini and lets them open up to an extent that is hard to find and comprehend by a Gemini. It says nothing about Aries. And nothing about Scorpios either, so anyway.